Hello and welcome to So Sandler's Pod, the Adam Sandler podcast, a podcast where we discuss the movies of famed architect Adam Sandler. My name is Kerry Jones, and as always, I am joined by my dearest friend and co-host, Matt Wolstenholme.
Welcome to 2023, everybody. It's going to be a big year.
Happy New Year. Matt, do you remember last episode when we said, oh, we're sorry we haven't recorded in a while, but we're going to amp things up and record weekly?
Yeah, we didn't say when, though.
So, yeah, we took another mini break over Christmas. And, yeah, just...
I was sick over Christmas. It was a bit shit. New Year's.
Yeah, there we go. So, illness has pulled us away from the pod for just over 2 months.
Jesus. I thought last time I recorded was in December.
Yeah, it was, but the time before that was late October.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, right, it was. Yeah, we missed a while. All right, well, we've been slacking, everyone. We're back at it now.
Good news, though, we did only just finish watching this week's movie, so it should be kind of fresh in our head, despite watching it a month ago as well.
I mean, we've literally finished watching this within the last 30 minutes. Like, there's no reason we should forget any.
I'm quite worried that I'm going to. This week's movie is Adam Sandler's Click. Matt, what's your history with this movie?
So I've seen this as a kid. Didn't really remember it. And I watched it a few years ago. And completely forgot the twist at the end. So I was like, oh yeah, that happened. And then I rewatched it again, obviously, the last couple of months. And I've been like, oh yeah, okay. But no, this was a lot easier to get through than I thought it would be. And yeah, I enjoyed it a lot more than I thought I would. I thought it was a much worse movie from memory.
Yeah, I remember hating this film when I was younger. And I don't know why. Maybe because it was a bit more, I want to say grown up. But there is a scene where Adam Sandler farts in David Hasselhoff's face, so maybe grown up.
There is a lot of crotch shots in there. There's a lot of slapstick in this.
But on rewatch, I thoroughly enjoyed this movie.
I mean, don't get me wrong, times two speed probably did help, but I can't say I have any like quarrels with this, like majorly anyway. Like, I thought it was thoroughly. So it's a good watch. Like, it's an easy movie to watch.
Times 2 speed didn't feel too fast either.
No.
Like, it was a night.
It was okay.
It was a nice watch at the times 2 speed.
If you've never listened to anything in times 2 before, don't jump straight to times 2.
It was a breezy 45 minutes. Start with 1.5. Yeah.
It depends where they're from, because like people from America, they're like way easier to listen to on faster speeds. But like, say if you're listening to someone that's English or Irish or from Europe, it's so much fucking harder.
You do everything times two.
Yeah, because I don't know what it is. I just hate listening to slow people, so I just no reason. I don't even have time to get back in the day. It's just I'd rather watch a 10-minute video in 5 minutes.
I mean, yeah, nobody can blame you for that one. So yeah, this week's movie is Click.
The most awesome force in the universe, the most powerful device ever created, is now in the hands of one man.
Cool.
You wanted a universal remote? That remote controls your universe.
For me to do those documents, it's gonna take me months.
And you better get started.
Wow, I got a big headache.
You do?
So I can re-experience any part of my life I want to.
I heard a song playing on the radio this morning.
We have a song?
The song that was playing during our first kiss.
What the hell is that song?
Do you have
oh my god! Get it? That's my boy.
Linger was playing during our first juicy kiss. You look beautiful in that pink sweater.
Honey, you remember what I was wearing?
I love you.
I love you too, honey.
Yeah.
skipping showering, skipping getting dressed, and looking sexy. I like that.
Have you been drinking, Daddy?
The remote.
Making up.
Click it.
Is that my parents?
They're making you.
Get me out of here!
Takes control.
This thing's broken. He's fast forwarding on its own. What else did I miss?
Every day.
Adam Sandler.
You look a little pale there, pal. Let me fix that.
Don't get the Hulk angry. You won't like him when he's angry.
Click.
Plants catch?
Yeah, but your kid stinks.
A regular Derek Jeter right there.
Is a 2006 American comedy film directed by Frank Coraci, written by Steve Corin and Mark O'Keefe, and produced by Adam Sandler. The movie stars Adam Sandler, Kate Beckinsale as his wife Donna, and Christopher Walken as Morty. But also
great
in this movie, fantastic cast. We also have Henry Winkler as Adam Sandler's dad. Sean Austin's back. And
yes.
Adam Sandler's mother is played by Julie Carver. Do you know who Julie Carver is?
Only because I Googled it before this.
Yeah.
But I would not have known that name off the top of my head. Like, I probably should know just from like visual memory, but like, no, I had no idea that was Marge Simpson.
Yeah, she's Marge Simpson. What the hell?
That's fucking incredible. Shout out to that lady.
Who else is in this movie? David Hasselhoff. He's in this movie.
Oh.
Jonah Hill. He's in this movie.
I didn't know that. Watching this, that was fucking hilarious.
Jennifer Coolidge.
He just comes out of nowhere.
She's in this movie.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Cameron Monaghan. Nick Swanson. Yeah. Terry Crews is in this, for fuck's sake.
I didn't notice it was Cameron Monaghan at first.
I didn't either. I just know him. So that kid, I just remember him from the Malcolm in the Middle when Dewey goes to like the remedial class and he's the kid with the fucking mittens on that can't like have scissors and shit. He just bites people.
Well, that kid
and became that kid's now Cameron Monaghan.
And he became the Joker.
Yeah,
at some point.
And some sort of the Joker in Gotham.
Yeah, an unnamed version of the Joker. Because they didn't have the rights or something. I don't know. So, Matt, just moving on quickly to our first little segment, a segment I like to call Curb That Blurb. So what I've done is I have found a plot synopsis somewhere online and you've got to decide whether we curb that blurb. And by curb that blurb, I mean if we hit it, take it outside, make it bite the pavement and kick it in the back of the head. So I did do something really clever and I went on that script.ai thing and it was like, write the plot synopsis for the movie, click. But I didn't copy it down, so this one's from...
Oh, what the fuck?
It wasn't in my notes.
We are the worst podcast in the world. Just like, so here's what we would have done if we had, like, if we just weren't complete morons. It's like, yes. It would be really good if we could remember.
So, from Google, an architect discovers a universal remote that permits him to fast forward and rewind to certain points in his life.
Ah, you know what? Oh, nah, you've ruined it with the AI thing. I want the AI one now. I want to know what it said. No, that's short and sweet, but it's shit, Kermit. But...
Right. Yeah, I think we should... I'm sorry, I didn't copy.
If someone was like, give me this film in like 12 words, banging.
Yeah.
Absolutely spot on.
But fuck it, let's Kermit. 12 of it. I've also found a couple of reviews for this movie online as well. So this comes from Paul Arendt from the BBC. And
what, not
they
Paul
said,
Allen? Oh, Paul Allen was dead.
Paul
Arendt. No, I'm just joking. I was making a reference, but that just went straight over everyone's head.
Like, who's Paul Allen?
From American Psycho. It's the guy that dies in there, who he's like getting interviewed about. Or the guy he kills. And then they're just interviewing Patrick Bateman for the movie about it. He's the guy played by Jared Leto.
Oh, right, okay. I've watched that movie once.
That was a terrible reference.
And I'm going to send you a message now, but I'm going to have to cut this out.
Gary's going to edit. Are you Facebook messaging me, or are you messaging me on here?
No, Facebook.
Okay. I'm not going to say what it is, but how the fuck?
I don't know.
Oh, I feel so bad for everyone listening, but fucking hell, that's, I can't say that. That's so funny. But I won't.
That's pretty messed up, isn't it?
So fucking funny. It's a strange scenario, but that's so funny. Did you copy that scene?
I did watch the first 10 minutes and then, yeah.
Okay, well, if you've seen the movie, there's a very, very, like, ironic scene there that would, like, relate. That's fucking hilarious.
So what I've done is I found a couple of reviews online. So this one comes from Paul Arendt from the BBC, and they say, when the DVD comes out, I'm going to buy it and fast forward through the whole thing. You know, for vengeance. Which I think it's very funny, but I don't think it's fair in this movie.
No, that's a very funny review. I will give him that. That's good quality.
And then
this movie deserves a watch, at least half a watch. Give it half an hour at least.
Just put it on times two.
Oh yeah, just put it on times two, and half an hour is most of the movie, so you're almost done.
Then I have found a 1-star review from Nacho Norwal. And they say, it's a wonderful life for racists, sexists, and morons. And
I mean, ignorance is bliss, so yeah, fucking hell.
And then I have found I mean, this movie is kind of sexist.
I've never watched A Wonderful Life, but like, it's just that movie where the guy's like, oh, I'm such a cunt, and then kills himself, and then fucking gets shown that he's not a cunt, and then he's not a cunt.
That movie. Yeah. That's the movie. And then I have found a review here from Jack, and they say, speechless. Adam Sandler is a generational talent. This movie made me feel things I didn't even know I was capable of feeling. Click redefined cinema in ways that no film before it did, and no film after ever could. Never before have I been so invested in not just a character, but a human life. Sandler's Oscar-worthy performance as Michael Newman is so real, raw, and relatable that you feel every twist and turn of the story, every bump along the road of his life, and as if it were happening to you. As Michael fast-forwards through his life's most important moments, you can't help but feel as the time is slipping away from you as well. This film serves as a stark reminder to enjoy the little things in life before you know it, when Christopher Walken will show up and hand you a magical remote of unexplained origin, giving you the power to move through the curse of your own life with a click of a button. Click blurs the lines between comedy, drama, and existential horror in a way that a select few pieces of art can. Just as Michael Newman crossed the threshold from Bed Bath into the beyond, this movie has crossed the threshold from obscurity to cementing its place in cinema history. Forever and ever, babe.
Who wrote that?
His name was Jack.
Where was it published?
On Letterboxd.
Someone get that man a job. Jesus Christ. If that's not a fucking resume, I've never seen one. Jesus Christ. That guy's trying to get hired by someone. Fucking hell. That was good to do.
Look,
that's like, take yourself way too seriously and absolutely fucking run with it. You nailed it. So, fuck it off. Can't argue with it. The only thing... Actually, I will agree with one point. I agree that Adam Sandler is a generational acting talent.
Yeah,
He's thoroughly and unequivocally survived and like made it through at least two generations of movies and is still as popular as he probably ever was. So fuck it up.
No, yeah. No, if you think
about
it.
Literally became his own production company, for fuck's sake. Like, what do you mean?
Yeah. No.
Most of the generational talent. There's not, even if you don't think he's a great actor, like, he is a generational talent. And, like, how many fucking people do you know that get an entire production company and just make films for their best friends for the rest of their life?
He makes films that he enjoys, but the fact that he's been nominated for a couple of big things in the last couple of years shows that that talent is...
And he's only gotten better, yeah.
And always has been there.
And consistent. Like, yeah, fair enough. Some of these films in the mid-2000s and, like, specifically around, like, 2008 to 2011, they're just pretty dog shit. But, like, you know... I'm pretty sure everyone's fucking filmography's got some stinkers on there. Nah, I don't know. We obviously are a bit biased because we're doing a podcast about it, but I just don't think he deserves all the shit that he gets.
So, taking those reviews and that beautiful, I want to say essay from Jack into consideration, how do you feel this movie fared on Rotten Tomatoes? What do you think the critics give this out of 100?
I think the critics probably rinsed this purely because of, like, the ending. Like, just the... Well, I mean, we're obviously going to spoil this, so, like, it was all a dream. Like, is like, don't get me wrong, like, it's a good movie, and then you kind of do that, the movie kind of means nothing at the end. So, like, I can't imagine the critics getting this a good score. I'm going to go with, like, at best, like, a 40%.
So critics give this a 34%, and the audience?
Audience. I think people would probably be upset with the ending as well. I think people would not like that, just because of, like, it's been overdone, but I still think about 60-ish.
Yes, 66.
60, okay. I probably would have said a flat 60, so.
And then this movie...
I think that's fair, like...
I think it's fair.
It's not exactly, it's not a great movie, but, like, it's definitely worth a watch. It's watchable and it's funny.
It is funny.
Oh, you'll get some laughs out of it. You'll definitely get some laughs out of this movie.
So this movie had a budget of $82 million, $240 million at the box office. So it was the box office success.
Yes.
Right. Shall we get into the plot? Like I said, I don't have the plot from Wikipedia, so I just have my notes to go off. So hopefully we could try to fumble our way through.
I'm pretty sure he did that. The first scene is him, like, waking up and he's just trying to faffle through, like, 10 different remotes and his dog's humping the fucking duck.
So the movie opens up with the kids wanting to watch TV, but Adam Sandler doesn't know how to turn the TV on with his remote, and then his kid's like, but the old Doyle has a universal remote. And then,
oh, Doyle's rule!
And then, the dog's fucking the duck.
That dog is fucking the duck. Throughout the whole film, never stops fucking that duck.
Well, he does.
Hey. All right, that duck never stops getting fucked, anyway.
Their son Ben's like, oh, you need to get a universal remote like the O'Dials. It literally controls everything in the house. And he's like, yeah, whatever. And then he's got to get to work. So on the way to work, he's just stuck in traffic and he misses the start of the meeting with Prince Habibu.
Prince Hubba Bubba. And Prince Hubba Bubba Bubba Bubba. Fuck me, that's Rob Schneider and some Arab face.
Like Rob Schneider said, he is a part of the human race and he's just playing other people in the human race.
Damn right.
Okay. So what, he's designing a club for them?
I think they're designing a bar restaurant thing.
Yeah.
And he's trying to make it, like, fancy and bougie, and this guy's like, nah, fuck it, make the bar longer, I just want hookers and strippers.
let's pull the water feature out, stick a big plug in the middle for wet t-shirt content.
And that seems to be a theme for the movie. He's fucking up with these water features. Every time he puts a water feature in there, it's ruining the thing.
And then, yeah, so he's in the meeting with Prince Abibu and his boss, David Hasselhoff. And then after this meeting, David Hasselhoff promises Sandler a promotion if he can get a contract from the Japanese for a multi-million dollar hotel. So they're in his office and like, see that parking lot over there? Japanese want to build a hotel there. And then Sandler's like, okay, I'm going away this weekend. Can I do it next week? Like, no, Japanese can't wait. They don't even wait for the fish to be cooked.
Well, I wrote this down. It's like, can it wait 3 days? 3 days? These guys are Japanese. They don't even wait for their fish to cook. I thought that was a great line. That was fucking hilarious.
Next scene. They
he's late to the swim meet.
Yeah, the swim meet. I think this is one of my favorite scenes. Where Sandler just runs up kids. It's like, right. You're not my dad. It's like, I could be.
As far as you know.
You're my little dad.
So he just goes up to this.
Just ruining this Asian kid's life.
And then he finally finds his son. And then his son's like, I just saw you arrive. And you went up to the wrong kid. And then Sean Austin's here as the swim coach.
When Aston arrives, turns up, Big Papa in his Speedo.
Big Papa in his Speedo. And then after the swim meet, what do you know, family gathering for 4th of July. And we meet Sandler's parents by Henry Winkler and Marge Simpson.
Goddamn right. What an iconic couple. The Bonds and Marge.
I feel like...
Winkler's definitely been on The Simpsons at least once.
He must have done.
No way he's not been on The Simpsons.
If he hasn't, the Fonz has.
That's what I mean. Like, there's no way there's not like a Happy Days reference in there somewhere.
So, Henry.
Also, while you're searching this up, they're doing this 4th of July little camping cookout. And Henry Winkler does this little magic trick that's like a theme throughout the movie where he gets a coin and he like bites a bit off the coin and then spits it. And the coin like reattaches back together. And it's a good little trick. And apparently Henry Winkler can do that trick in real life. And does it like when like he sees like kids and come up to him and like take pictures with him and stuff.
So
according to IMDb. So that's a lie, I apologize, but that seems like something like cool guy Henry Winkler would do.
Henry Winkler, he was in The Simpsons. He was in an episode called he's in an episode called Take My Wife, Sleaze. And I believe, yes.
What season?
Season 11, episode 8. And it's the one where Homer wins a vintage Harley Davidson. And then the bikers just come to his house and just takes over, pretty much. And he plays the character.
Rolling through the house and spitting tobacco all over the floor.
So guest appearance in this episode is John Goodman as Meetuk and Henry Winkler as Ramrod.
Is that the one where they have like the chain whip fight?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. And then, the Fonz has popped up as well in this instance.
Oh, I think I was thinking of Fonz. They have the fucking circus people over and they invade the house.
The carny folk,
yeah, fucking hell.
Throughout this family gathering, Sandler's just on his phone and he's threatening kids who are using fireworks, and his parents hate this, pretty much.
Yeah.
Then at home, Sandler's like, we need to cancel the camping trip. And then everybody's pissed at him, so he just storms off to Bed Bath and Beyond to get a remote because he hits himself in the head with a drone.
Yeah, he fucking flies a remote control helicopter directly into his eyeball.
This movie is literally
it's
just this collection of scenes. Like, watching it was fun, but poking through it.
It is quite skitty, just with, like, especially based on the fact some of the movies him just fast forwarding to different bits that are like relevant, and especially like for the fact that he's literally fast forwarding through the boring bits of his life.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, that, I see you.
And then,
we get to Bed Bath & Beyond. And we get to the bed, then we get to the bath, and then we get to Beyond.
But before we get to the bath, Beyond.
So we get to bed first.
And then we get...
All this? It's like, bath, 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 bed. And he has a little, lie down.
Bath. Nick Swartzen, bed.
Nick Swartzen, who is... This must be like one of his first films. He's so young looking in this.
He pops up too much in these movies.
He's everywhere. He's fucking all over him.
What movie? I think it's
either Grown Ups 2, where he's just like fucking like crackhead.
He's the bus driver, isn't it?
Yeah.
Nick Swartzen's there. He's too famous. And then Sandler falls on the bed and discovers the Bond section. Then I've written down a little theory here. Christopher Walken is the Doctor or future Morty using Rick's technology. And I've come to this conclusion because he has curly hair like Tom Baker. He wears a bow tie like Matt Smith. And Beyond and Way Beyond is just the TARDIS.
Are you trying to say that Doctor Who is the angel of death?
Possibly. Because Sandler walks in and it's like, oh, it's a lot bigger.
That would make a lot of sense.
You know?
No, he does. No, but I'm sorry. On that point, I was watching this, and on a rewatch, it's like it's quite obvious this is now just a dream, because he just walks into a room that is now just like it is just the TARDIS, and then he's like, "Oh, like even more beyond, or like brand new." And he opens this case; it's got like 20 shelves, and there's only one shelf full. Just got this remote, and it's like, all right, so yeah, but no, yeah, I just thought like, okay, so this is just a dream now, but. It makes more sense when you rewatch it.
Yeah. And then, like you said, Morty just grabs the remote from an empty shelf and gives it to Sandler. The barcode's not in the system. Just take it for free.
Yeah.
But you can't return it. And then Sandler's like, where the hell would I return something I got for free? And then Sandler takes the remote home.
Hijink sensor.
Yeah, pretty much. He uses it on the TV, and that works fine. And then his wife comes down and starts arguing with him. So he pauses the TV, but he accidentally pauses his wife at the same time.
Yeah.
But he doesn't realize. And then sometime down the line, he finds out the remote is magic because he turns the volume down on the dog and he makes him shit faster.
So I got it. I've got the note, and it's like he's always, like, throughout this, he's just really sick and unhealthy. Like, he's always, like, just a little bit sick. He's always, a little bit sick in this. And he's always just eating shit food. He's just eating Twinkies and ding-dongs and fucking whatnot all the whole movie. And then, I've just got my note here. Says, Paul's his wife, comma, turns down dog, comma, fast forward.
That's what I've got as well. And then I've got a note saying, Stifler's mom genuinely laughed at that.
Jennifer Coolidge. Yeah. What a fucking legend.
She is... What is Sandler's wife's
Golden
name?
Golden Globe winner.
What's Kate Beckinsale's name in this movie? Donna?
I think it's Donna.
Is it Donna? Donna Newman? Yes, it is Donna.
That rings a bell.
And then, so Jennifer Coolidge is here. Sandler doesn't like her because she just finds her annoying as fuck, so he mutes her. Then I've got a note saying, Kevin is a little prick and robo-dog.
Yeah, my thing here literally just says robo-dog. That's so fucking funny. He's just like, fuck you, this dog costs more than your car. He just runs it straight over. Not anymore, sonny. fuck.
And then, he runs over robo-dog, going back to Bed Bath & Beyond because he's like, Morty, I'm on a reality show. Where's the cameras?
Yeah, he doesn't believe anything.
And then Morty's like, "No, it's not a trick. This is how the remote works." So they go into a digital landscape, and then we got voiceover from James Earl Jones.
Then he's the narrator.
Yeah, and then we go to the special features and find the making of, which is, his name's not Paul Newman. What's his name in this movie?
Teddy. I think it's Theodore. Sorry, it's Teddy.
It's Michael.
What is it? Nah, on his gravestone.
Oh,
oh, no. I thought it was his dad.
Yeah, no, his dad's Ted.
Oh, fuck, yeah, right, okay.
Yeah, so, where am I? Then we see his parents having sex, and then next thing you know, we're in the womb, and then Sandler's giving birth to, and he's got a tiny penis.
Yes, tiny schmeckle.
Tiny schmeckle, it's like a tic-tac. And then we go to the lake, and my only note for the lake is pretty good makeup. So I was on the Wikipedia page for this movie. This was...
Are you talking about the de-aging of Henry Winkler?
Yeah. This movie was nominated for an Oscar.
Really?
for best makeup.
What, for makeup? That's fucking incredible.
This is the Sandler movie to... Pan's Labyrinth.
Fair enough.
That's... Which is understandable. Yes,
yeah. Any other year, you may have won that, but you get run over by a fucking freight train there. Jesus.
I'm still furious about, 2012? When Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows lost to the Iron Lady. So, all the goblin makeup, all the troll makeup, all that lost to making Meryl Streep look like a right.
I could have gone the rest of my life without you trying to piss me off with Margaret Thatcher. I'm not gonna lie. I think like the biggest Oscar snub of all time is Forrest Gump winning over The Shawshank Redemption and Pulp Fiction. It's fucking wild.
And then I've got a note saying, "Can I go to the bathroom?" What's that?
I've got the exact same note, and it's his assistant comes over and just gives him a note that just says, "Can I go to the bathroom?" Because she's like, she won't go to the bathroom by herself, so she's like, "Well, I have to ask permission."
And then the next
creepy assistant who has a sex change in the middle of this movie. For some
And then I'm guessing we're back at home because I've got the next thing I've got is actually we're playing some drop. Because the O'Doyle kid and Ben are playing catch outside.
Oh, I've got... He's on autopilot. He's realised he's on autopilot for, the boring stuff. And it keeps, jumping in forwards. Because they go through and he's like, "Oh, I missed all that dinner. What do you mean?" And
he goes through,
I'm a zombie.
That's after... Actually, we're playing some drop. And then he just skips the entire day for the first time. Yeah, so then... Then he's like,
"Oh yeah, parents are coming over for food." Fucking puts his hand down.
Yes, so he gets hit in the nuts, and then he's skipping through the meal with his parents. And then the next note I've got is after he skips everything is, did Sandler offer to put his dick in his mother's mouth?
Yes, I thought that as well. I was like, "What the fuck?" He's called it a little tic tac. He's like, "Yeah, come here, I'll freshen your breath."
And then
that's so fucked up.
And then he fast forwards the fight, fast forward to sex. Did you notice the clock?
The clock goes for 3 minutes.
Yeah.
Skips ahead, yeah.
And then he just tells his wife, "Oh, I'll get you next time." And then
and then
he goes to ring Morty, and then Morty shows up. And then he finds out that he's on autopilot. And then we have a look throughout the day, and he's literally just a blank canvas. There's nothing going on.
Fuck, I missed a bit there. But I've fucking found where I am now. I've got my notes in.
Maybe you can explain this. I've got a quote, all in caps. "What is this, Animal Planet?"
Yeah, they're searching through his previous, girlfriends. But he's like, "How did you end up with a woman like Donna?" And he's like, "Hey, you should have seen the ladies I was getting before. They were all good looking." And then it's just like an androgynous person for the first one. They have no idea, male or female. Then the second one is just some really fat lady with super, super hairy arms.
And then, I remember that. And then after this, he starts to fast forward his entire life. He's fast forward illnesses, yeah. showers, traffic jams.
Oh yeah. So like, because yeah, because he gets to like Terry Crews, and he's just like, "Fuck this."
Mute. Yeah. So Terry.
Am I skipping ahead?
No, we're on Terry Crews now because he's sick after he gets sick that night. Fast forwards 2 days.
Yeah, and he wakes up and he's not sick anymore.
And then the shower's cold. So he fast forwards that as well. And then he's stuck in traffic and Terry Crews shows up.
Yeah. And then I was watching this, and then so obviously the Terry Crews scene happens, he meets him, and then it's like the jogging scene.
Yeah.
So the version I had skipped this scene completely.
What?
It wasn't there. So I was watching it, and then like the jogger like comes into screen, so it's like, and I completely forgot about this. And I watched it and was like, oh my god, no way, it's this scene. I completely forgot this. Like, I've still got the quote in my head from when I was like fucking 12. But like, the jogger came on screen, and then the next, like, it literally just jump cut and he was parked up. And I was like, wait, what the fuck?
Is it the Barney quote you have in your head?
It's when the jogger's going and he fucking like slow-mos her and her boobs are going up and down and he's like, let's slow things down for a better look. It's like so creepy. But so he completely skips that scene. Like the version that I watched on the internet was just like, fucking, nope, that doesn't exist. We're not having that.
That is some awful censorship.
Oh, it was horrific.
I've got a theory here. I think Terry Crews is the same guy the guy from White Chicks.
God, I hope so.
Singing in the cars.
It's set in New York.
Has to be. And then I've got a note in Slow Ball.
Yeah. And that's the scene that I didn't get.
And then in the car, he decides to change his color. So first he turns himself into the Hulk. Then he turns himself into Barney and he sings, I love you, you love me. Jogger had some big boobies.
Mm. Which was just an insult to injury after it skipped over the scene.
And then finally he gives himself a nice tan.
Yes. And then he gets in and they're going in for sexual harassment talk. And he's what? He's like, anyone can be sexually harassed. So David Hasselhoff's giving this fucking speech and he is just like sexual harassment on legs. And he's giving this speech. He's like, anyone can be harassed at work. A man, a woman, even the office slut. I'm looking at you, Stacey.
Yeah.
It was fucking gold. It's like watching Michael Scott give a fucking sexual harassment seminar. It's brilliant.
It's kind of problematic though.
It is. It's not appropriate, but it's funny. So fuck it. It's a movie.
That is like, and the next slide, homosexual harassment.
But he doesn't really go through. It just kind of is like, so this is when a guy comes up to another guy, says something like, "Not cool," something like that. And then it goes into, like, he gets, like, fast-forwarded and it goes into Spanish and he makes it look different.
He changes the aspect ratio, changes language, blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
And then after the sexual harassment seminar, they're in the meeting with the Japanese people and they're, like, showing everything. And then the Japanese people go to the bar to have a chat and Sandler uses the translation feature on the remote to find out what they're actually thinking. And then, like, this guy watched a documentary on Asian architect. The fountain shit. He's got an egghead. Let's fuck these people off and go to TJ Fridays.
I fucking hate both of these guys. They're boring as shit. None of this. Let's go to America's greatest cultural edition TGI Fridays.
Do some jello shots. And then they come back to the table and it's like, listen, we had this all wrong. Let's rip up these. Trust us with your money and we'll fuck this place off and go to TJ Fridays. The old guy's just like, heck yeah!
Yes. Old Asian men getting high and getting fucking fucked up on jello shots at TGI. I'm sure that'd be a good time.
And then, they get the contract then. So, to celebrate Sandler goes home and he gets
all his kids some bikes.
He buys some bikes, buys his wife a handbag, and everyone's super happy. And then Sandler's wife asks him about their song. He's like, oh, what's our song?
What is our song? It's song it was playing, that song, yeah, I know the song, it was, And then he pauses, main menu, take me back to the good memories. The cheat code.
Yeah, cheat code, and then they just go back to the bar where they had their first kiss, and they're just, sharing their notes. Yeah, it's...
It was their first song, I think.
So, yeah, Something by the Cranberries, and Jennifer Coolidge here, she has Bart Simpson on the top, which is a nice yes. little reference. But yeah.
Jennifer Coolidge playing Bart Simpson.
And then we're back in the office, and Hasselhoff is a prick. He's like, oh,
yes.
You're not a partner yet. Oh, you need to do all this.
You thought you were a partner.
And then Sandler just pauses life, slaps Hasselhoff silly, and then farts in his face. Yeah?
Good scene. Good revenge.
Stacey, did you put shit in my lunch?
I taste shit. He's like chewing his mouth as well. He's like, I can taste it.
And then Sandler visits Morty and he's like, oh, listen, I want a monster, my promotion. Like, what am I going to miss? A couple of arguments and a haircut. And Morty's
yeah,
like,
he's what he's thinking. He's like, is it 3 months or is it 3 months that he thinks he's going to miss?
Yeah. He's like, he thinks he's going to miss like 2 or 3 months.
Yeah.
So he's thinking about it, and Morty's like, yeah, that's a stupid idea. So he goes back home, and then his kids bring him ideas for buildings. And he's like, a bedroom made of pizza? That's dumb. What have you made? Hallway made of French fries? So he's just a little... He's a prick.
Just being
an
arsehole to his kids.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then he decides, oh, I'm going to go outside and have a cigar. And then Kevin's like, hey, this is our new RV. It has a 52-inch plasma, surround sound, 3 showers. And I can sleep 6.
It's our RV. It's better than your house. Fuck you.
And then Sandler decides to get revenge because Kevin's mother comes outside and is like, oh, I caught Kevin with a cigar. I think it's got some weed in it. And then Kevin just gets slapped silly by his mother.
He's in for a rough night, that kid.
This kid is such a good actor.
Yeah, he's great in this. It's fucking hilarious.
And then I've got his wife is trying to get the bikes off the kids because they need to return it.
Yeah, like, what? I don't get it. I already told everybody I've got a new bike. This is bullshit.
I don't think there's... If they're living in that house, he's working in New York City. There's no need to return the bikes.
Look, like...
Just
this
cut something
make sense. Yeah, like,
just cut
no
something
reason.
Else out of the budget, you know? Just don't buy Twinkies for 2 months. Like, yeah. There's no way that kids' bikes can be that expensive. You know?
No, I mean, I've got no idea. I've never bought a kid's bike, but you're not wrong. With the fact that they're living in, like, a fucking 4-bedroom house.
Yeah. In the suburbs of New Jersey. And then Sandler's like, oh, listen, I'm just going to fast forward. So he fast forwards. And lo and behold, he's fast forwarded over a year.
He realizes it's what, just over a year?
Just over a year.
I think they said just over a year.
Hasselhoff and Jennifer Coolidge, they are now married, even though she cheated on Hasselhoff with his brother.
Classic.
Alice has become Alan.
Yes.
And Sandler and his wife are in therapy.
Yes. And he has no idea why.
Has no idea why. And then back of the house, he wants to watch Dragon Tail or Dragon Spin or whatever it's called with his kids. He's like,
Dragon Tail,
hey. I'm like, hey, that show's for kids. Let's watch some CSI instead. So he's starting to realize how much he's missed. Because Sundance the dog is also dead. And now they have a new rat dog called Peanut.
Yeah, they bought like a fucking chihuahua.
that's
a step down going from a fucking golden retriever to a fucking chihuahua. Like, fuck it. That's an insult right there.
The way that this dog just comes out from under the sofa is pretty funny.
Yeah, she just like appears out of nowhere. Come here, you little gremlin. Give me my fucking Twinkie.
And then he finds out auto fast forward has become a thing, which fast forward the things that he has fast forward before.
Yeah, so it's now like skipping on its own and just fucking
yeah,
living his life for him.
So he tries to give the remote back to Morty, but finds it impossible. He destroys it, bins it, throws it away. But whatever he does, it just comes back to him. And this
sucks. It's like it's glued. They ain't going yeah. nowhere. Can't this, return it.
This auto fast forward has caused Sandler to refuse to shower, to change his clothes, and to drive into work. So he ends up going into work on a bike. In his,
yes, crossing in the Brooklyn Bridge on a bike in a gown.
Because he's terrified of auto fast forward. And he gets into work, and Hasselhoff and Jennifer Coolidge have decided to move to Morocco. So Sandler gets another promotion.
Hey.
And because what he fast
forwards. He uses the same name here. I wrote it down. He uses Eric Lamonsoff. He always uses Eric Lamonsoff. He fucking does. I've noticed it now. I've got you, you son of a bitch. And that's fucking Kevin James's name in Grown Ups.
Where was the first time
or
that
at least it's his surname. It was in something the other week, or a few months ago. I pointed it out. I can't remember where it was. But if anyone's listening, if you remember, I fucking pointed this out. And this bastard has been using the same name in all his movies, all these
years. Oh, Lamonsoff. And then, oh, it was in...
Did Lamonsoff.
It was in Wedding Singer.
Yes. Because someone's the name in the Wedding Singer.
Lamonsoff got married.
That, yes, people get married.
In the photo of a lady or something. Maybe.
Someone.
Yes, so he's offered a promotion, and because he fast-forwarded to his promotion before, oh, auto-fast-forward kicks in, and this time the remote has fast-forwarded.
CEO.
Yeah, he's the CEO of the company, the remote has fast-forwarded 10 years, and Sandler has put on, like, 250 pounds.
He's a large man. He's like, 400, 500 pounds in this, like, he's like... He's like 350 kilos. He's fucking massive.
He's massive. So he's...
He looks like a fucking hippo.
He's all confused with what's going on, so he decides to drive back to his house. And on the radio, he's listening to the news, and I've written this down. So the news report on the radio says, Michael Jackson, the first man to clone himself,
oh my God,
is now...
I wrote this down as well. This is the funniest line in the whole movie.
But sorry, Michael Jackson, the first man to clone himself, now suing himself for molesting himself.
That's just like a throwaway line as well. It's on the radio while he's driving the car.
That's probably the biggest laugh I had out of the...
That definitely got me the most for the whole film. That fucked me up, that.
Oh. And then he goes into the house and... Ben is on the sofa eating food, and it's just Jonah Hill with prosthetics on.
Yeah, Jonah Hill with like a lot of makeup on.
Yeah, and he's in it for like 30 seconds.
Yeah, he's literally just giving him shit for being fat, and he runs upstairs with lots of like lollies and junkies and shit. So,
Peanut's now dead, and they've got a third new dog.
Yes, a third dog. It was a lazy dog.
Who gets the duck to do all the work. And it is discovered that Donna and Michael have had a divorce. And now she is married to Sean Austin's character, Bill.
Yes. Good old Bill. Lifeguard Bill. Him and his speedo.
Yeah.
And then... Yeah, so they have a fucking massive argument. Because he's like, nah, this is bullshit. What do you mean? Nah, I'm not going through this again. And then... He tries to give her a note, and then the dog just fucking drops him to the floor.
First he pauses and kicks Bill in the nuts for stealing his wife.
Just absolutely crushes them balls.
And then I've got a note here saying, remote is lie proof, goes off Sandler's behaviour.
Yeah, so he's like, fuck, I didn't want to do all this.
He pauses and Morty shows up, doesn't he?
Yes. When he's,
and then
yeah, and his the extra juicy tracksuit.
Yeah. Yes, he is. And then the dog.
Big, is it like a juicy couture tracksuit with fucking like a velour one, and it's just got extra juicy written across the arse?
Does it?
Yeah, when he gets out of the car, that blue tracksuit he's wearing.
And then, yeah, like you said, he tries to give Donner a note, and this dog just comes and knocks him over, and he gets a head injury.
Yeah, like, fucking jumps up, like, paws on the chest, and he just cracks his fucking head off a wall.
And then it's
6 years later, it gets skipped.
Because Sandler previously found illness, it's now fast forward 6 years because the head injury led to cancer, discovering cancer.
Yes.
And then the chemo led to a heart attack. And then...
You're the only person in America that put on weight during chemo.
The remote has skipped 6 years because of the illness Sandler has had. And then... I've got a note saying fat flaps. And so he's had lipo and he's got these big flaps.
Yeah. the exaggeration of this is wild. It's like a plain pizza dough. Just like, I don't know how to describe it. It's like a dinner plate.
and then he's out of hospital. He runs into Ben. Ben's now skinny and he works in Sandler's firm as one of the architects, so they go up to Ben's office.
No longer played by Jonah Hill.
No. Played by... This guy's also... Played by Jake Hoffman.
What's he in?
He is in Sam and Kate. He's Sam. He's Steve Madden in The Wolf of Wall Street.
Okay. I'm not going to even fucking try and attempt that.
He's in.
He's
in a bunch of TV shows.
They didn't recognize him. I won't lie.
No, same. He's in Arrested Development. He's Jeff.
What season?
Fuck, I don't know. I was just gone through to Arrested Development. Okay.
Oh. Well, if he's not in the first two, don't give a shit.
We'll find out. No. He was in one episode in 2005.
Oh, so he was in the OG.
Yeah. And I don't know what episode.
Those original episodes of Arrested Development from like 2005 when it was like the first run, they're fucking amazing. It's so fucking funny. And then the remake, or like they brought it back and it wasn't as good.
Season 2, episode 7.
Is that the one where he fucking loses a hand?
I don't know. We go up to his office, and there's a picture of Ben with this girl, and Sandler like, blonde, good figure, she's pretty hot, and he's like, that's your daughter. Who is played by Katie Cassidy, who was Laurel Lance in Arrow.
What?
Did you watch Arrow? Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen all, that's a lie. I've seen like fucking 5 seasons of it, I guess.
Yeah, she's Laurel Lance in Arrow.
I need to Google this. I did not recognize her as Laurel Lance.
And then we also find out that...
What was her actual name?
Katie Cassidy.
Katie Cassidy. Yeah. Literally, like, didn't even ring a bell. Like, yeah, that's fucked. Completely missed that one.
And in this scene as well, we also find out that Sandler's dad is dead. But...
Yes.
He died peacefully in 2021, and it brought me some sort of solace knowing that he didn't die of COVID-19.
What?
He died peacefully. He just passed away.
It's 6 years, so this would be 2023. Current year.
But on the gravestone, it says 20.
All right. Oh, yeah.
There's a bunch of inconsistencies with the dates in this movie.
I'm sorry if anyone can hear those birds in the background, by the
way. And then, we just go back to the last time that Sandler saw Henry Winkler alive.
He's a massive cunt.
Because he's on autopilot.
He's a wanker.
He's literally not spoken to anyone nicely for years.
Yeah.
And he's a dick to his kid. He's a dick to his dad. He kicks off about the quarter trick. And then before Henry Winkler leaves, he says, "I love you, son." And we just get Michael wind in this little "I love you, son" a couple of times. And I think this is some of Sandler's best acting we've seen.
This was a good scene. I won't lie.
The heartbreak on his face.
Got a bit choked up. I was like, oh.
Yeah.
I can feel the scene. No, that was, this was, I mean, at acting wise, this was like the best acted scene in the whole thing, I'd probably say.
I think so as well. And then we've got Michael just visiting his father's grave. Find out that Morty is the angel of death.
Yeah, good old Morty.
Does he get into a fight with Morty?
Say that Morty was played by Christopher Walken? We did mention that, didn't we?
Yeah, we did, I think.
I was going to say, fucking hell, how did we miss that?
We must have done.
We have to.
And then he gets into a fight, and then Sandler panics, and it's like, just fast forward, please. So he fast forwards.
Oh,
yet again,
yeah.
To Ben's wedding. Correct? Yeah.
Yeah.
Sandler fast forward to Ben's wedding. And then I've got a note saying there's two World Trade Centers. And more fantastic makeup. Because the makeup on his mother is ridiculous.
Oh, yeah. Did you mean like the...
There's two...
I guess this is 2000. Yeah, this is later. There's like, it's like there's two World Trade Center ones.
Yeah.
It's so, yeah, it's, I don't know. It's just movies from 2006. Like, yeah, they were just guessing. I mean, they could definitely make a second one. It's not like out of the realm of possibility, but.
Yeah, they could.
They did not rebuild the same.
But
yeah, he has a heart attack.
Yeah. Michael and Donna dance their song, and then. Because Katie Cassidy calls Bill dad, he has a heart attack.
Yeah, just like triggers him. Just, nope, what does that even mean? I've ruined my life.
And then, yeah, doctors come and take him to the hospital.
He's in the hospital.
And he wakes up and Ben and Samantha are there. And then he's find out that Ben has cancelled his honeymoon to keep on working. And Sam's like, oh, this, don't do this.
Yeah, he's like, no, don't do that. That's a terrible idea. Family comes first.
Family comes first. And then his kids leave, and then Sandler decides to take himself off to run out into the rain in his hospital clothing, where he collapses on the floor. Kids come over with his ex-wife, and then he dies.
He just passes away right there in the street.
Yep.
And then, next scene. It was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Salt and Pepper and Heavy D up in the limousine. Nah, I'm just kidding. It was all a dream, though. And we fucking back in Bed Bath & Beyond, bitch.
I've got a note here saying... oh, yeah, so you collapse and everyone's there. Sorry. Tells Ben family comes first. Tells Samantha that he loves her. Tells Samwise, like, I think you're okay. And then he asks, he gives Donna the note from the bar, I'm guessing.
Oh,
will you still love me in the morning? And then he dies. And then next thing you know, like you said, all a dream, wakes up.
Bed Bath & Beyond. It's got a new lease on life.
And then
runs home.
He realizes he's back.
With gifts.
He realizes he's back to his younger self, gives Nick Swanson a hug, goes to see his parents, tells him that his penis has grown.
Yeah.
And then...
My penis grew. What did she say? She's like, well, it couldn't have gotten any smaller.
Then he goes home, decides to wake up
and then
entire family.
And she tells him to stay off the bong pipe.
Yeah, it's like, I can't promise that. Then he goes home, wakes everyone up. Like, I'm trying to... Then, like, what's going on? Then he kicks off, but... He's only joking kickoff because he's like, oh, I'm planning the camping trip. I'm going to fix the treehouse. Ben, I'm going to exercise with you so you don't become a fat fuck. Then he's like, oh, Samantha, I'm going to teach you calculus.
I'm just kidding, your mother will.
Yeah. And then he buys a new dog for Sundance to fuck. But they both decide to double double penetrate.
Is this the same bulldog from Little Nicky? Is this Beefy?
No. No, I don't. Beefy's probably dead.
No, this is only like fucking 5 years later. 6 years later.
No, it could be. But these dogs decide to DP the duck instead. And then Sander decides to call his dad to get the tent ready and realizes that the remote is back on the table. Dun, dun, dun. Hey.
Dun, dun, dun. Maybe it wasn't a train.
And then he just throws it in the bin.
Fuck yeah. Sure, Captain.
And then credits roll.
Me and you finished this movie at about the same time.
We did. I think there's like 3 minutes in it. So, question about the remote. If you had a magic remote to... Before we get into everything else, if you had a magic remote to fast forward your life, would you do it?
What? This confused me because there's a rewind button on there, isn't there? And he never uses it. He tries to use it when his like dad dies, but he wasn't there. So he rewinds to the bit where he saw him. So I'm like, why can't you just go back in time and do other shit?
Instead of being on autopilot.
Instead of like fucking keep going forward and forward and forward, you know, go back and do some shit as well. There's definitely a backwards button.
Yeah. Don't know.
So could like I didn't get that. I was always more of like, he's fucking fast forwarding everywhere. Can you not just like skip back to where he wanted to be and then just go from there?
So
I know obviously in the flashback, in like the rewind scene, he's not like in his own body, but I thought that was because he was going somewhere where his dad was dead.
So, yeah, he should be able to rewind to where he was. And he was where he was when he was on pilot.
Yeah. But or he's he just not in his own body. He's just like a view in himself.
Yeah. So maybe he can't rewind to
insert it. Shit. Well, that's not a universe. This is flawed. Flawed time travel.
So, would you use the remote or no?
I mean, the autopilot's fucking annoying as shit. I wouldn't want that. But, I could definitely fast forward a few hangovers. I wouldn't be too upset about it.
I think I could use the pause feature.
That's what I mean. What pauses, though? Like, is it just everything in your immediate vicinity, or does it pause everything?
I think it's probably time around you.
Okay, that's good. But then you'd just get older, and everyone else would be the same age if you did it for ages.
Yeah, but just pause for 20 minutes here or there. Just. So, Matt, before we give our scores, let's talk about our cream de la scene, which is our favorite scene of the movie. I think we both might have the same answer to this. But what was your favorite scene of the movie?
Him running over Robo Dog was quite funny. Just that little 1 second, fuck you. Wait, so I'm going to go with that. Just like. You know me, I always like to pick a scene where it's not actually a scene, it's just like a thing that happens for like a minute and it's the best bit in the movie. And I'm gonna go with that, him running over that. Because like later on you see that kid in the window like stroking his like taped together Robo Dog.
It's so good.
So yeah, my creme de la scene is Adam Sandler just being like another kid going, hey, this dog's worth more than your car. Not any fucking more, it's not.
Yeah, that's fair enough. I think I'm going to go with a bit more of a serious... I'm going to go with a scene, the last scene where he saw Henry Winkler alive. The acting on that Sandler was portraying here is the very start of something special that has carried on to this day.
Maybe that scene is what landed in his next role.
Maybe. Who knows? Right, Matt. Scores.
Scores.
How many sandbags out of 10 would you give this movie? And what sort of flood could those sandbags stop?
Can you tell me what movies I've got in the, like, between 6 and 7 range?
Anger Management.
Starting from low, going to high. Yeah.
Okay, so Coneheads, 6.7.
Jesus.
Airheads, 7. Dirty Work, 6.7. 8 Crazy Nights, 6.7. Anger Management, 6.7.
Fuck me, I love a 6.7, don't I? Jesus Christ.
Yeah, so those are your between 6 and 7. And then Mr. 7. Animal is 7.1. Yeah.
I'll give this a 7.1. Oh, no, I'll give it 7.2 for some variety. I'd say it's probably better than The Animal. It's probably not, but it was easy to watch.
7.2 sandbags.
I'm definitely giving a 7.2 sandbags, purely because I thought I was going to have a much worse time watching this than what I actually had. If that makes sense. I thought this was going to be like tough and shit and just like not good.
But it wasn't.
No, it was pleasantly. I was pleasantly surprised, and it was pretty funny. There was definitely some good laughs in there.
And what sort of flood could your sandbag stop?
The flood of tears every time Adam Sandler makes that redhead kid cry.
I am going to join you.
Cameron Monaghan, bullies his name. Every time Adam Sandler makes Cameron Monaghan cry.
I am also going to give this a 7.2. Nice. For the same reasons, I enjoyed this a lot more than what I thought I would. It was a lot more heartwarming than I thought it would be. It was a lot funnier than I thought it would be. And my 7.2 sandbags could stop the flood of Voss water that Ben has in his office. That just comes out of the...
That's a sick little shelf. Just comes open and there's just 8 fucking bottles of Voss water. Just like a rise and fall. Fucking...
Yeah.
No one should buy Voss water. If you want a glass bottle, go and buy a fucking glass bottle. You don't need a branded one. Fucking $9.
Well, but before we wrap up, do you have any pieces of trivia, goofs, or anything for this movie?
I think, other than the fact that Henry Winkler can do that trick and that's Marge Simpson. I don't think I had anything else.
Let me have a look.
Somewhere on Wikipedia.
Let me have a
is
look
there
through
interested
IMDb here. Dolores Rodian from the Cranberries. She was the one who sung the song at the end.
So, nice. So she was the one at the wedding?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. That's sick.
The Freedom Tower can be seen in New York City, except there are 2 towers where the World Trade Center once stood. We mentioned that. The nurse who attempts to sedate Michael in the hospital is Frank Coraci.
Oh, okay.
The director. And,
Yeah.
Don't think that's there's... It. Oh. This could have been number three in the Drew Times Sandler miniseries because Drew Barrymore turned down the part of Donna.
Yeah, probably good.
Yeah, I think
really in it enough for it to be like a Drew Barrymore role. Not that, like, in terms of an Adam Sandler film, like, they obviously are the main two, like, characters having the relationship, and the movie's generally about them when they're in it. So I feel like this is very Adam Sandler heavy, and like, Kate Beckinsale's definitely a secondary character in this.
She's very secondary in this, in this movie. I did read a goof earlier that I wanted to mention. Because it didn't make any
sense. Love Kate Beckinsale. Definitely not a knock on her. Just like, it's not exactly like The Wedding Singer or fucking 50 First Dates.
This movie's quite a lot
different. This is obviously like a very centralized on Adam Sandler role. Or movie.
Yeah, it's a very Sandler heavy
film.
So there's a factual error in this movie. Ben and Samantha are 2 years apart. The end credits depict 3 actors for both Ben and Samantha. At different ages. At the start of the movie, Ben is 7 and Samantha is 5. Then after the 1 year jump, Ben is 8 and Samantha is 6. Then 10 more years pass, Ben is 18. The credits say he's 17 and Samantha is 16, but the credits say she's 40. Then there's a 6 year jump. Ben is 24 and Samantha is 22. The credits say that she is 27. So if we went off the credits, at some point in time, Samantha suddenly became older than Ben.
What the fuck?
And
Someone in the credits just couldn't be asked and just fucking wrote the wrong name, the wrong numbers for someone.
Right. Apart from that, I have nothing else to say. Do you have anything else to say? Do you want to let the people know what we're doing next week?
Yeah, tune in next week for Rain on Me. And if you've never heard of that movie, that's because no one else has either.
Is it called Rain on Me? Or is it Rain Over
Me? It might be Rain on Me. I don't know. Rain Over Me, possibly then. Yeah, that's what I mean. I've seen the first half of this movie twice for no reason.
Rain Over Me is the movie. Rain on Me is the song.
Banger.
Okay, apparently Rain on Me is a song by Ariana Grande.
Oh, not that one. That's not the song I'm referring to, at least.
If you want,
but yeah, Rain Over Me next week. It's a has a somewhat of a connection to this movie and the fact that there's two World Trade Center ones in it. I'll just let everyone know next week is literally a movie about Adam Sandler, like, as a grieving family man because he lost all of his family in 9/11. Like, it's a movie. It's not easy to sit through. If you want to skip next week, I wouldn't fucking blame you. But if you want to learn about a movie that you've probably never seen, join us in. And we will be as respectful as possible.
Did I say the wrong name at the start? Did I say the wrong name at the start of this podcast? Did I say So Sandler's Pod or did I say So Sandler?
I cannot remember.
I was just thinking about it.
You know what? I'm sure some... we own both, don't we?
Yeah.
Fuck them. Don't care.
if you want, follow us on Instagram at SoSandrasPod. Send us an email at SoSandrasPod@gmail.com. Leave us a nice 5-star review on Apple Podcast and Spotify. And apart from that, goodbye.
We'll see you next week for some depression.